Hans Jakob, I know, to be honest, we are really proud that you and Inspari joins Valantic. Inspari ideally complements our portfolio, the Valantic service offering. Mm. Where do you see the strategic fit between Valantic and Inspari?
So first of all, we're very happy to be part of the Valantic family. We're very impressed with the journey that you've been on. And despite, you know, Inspari being a much smaller company, I think there are some similarities in terms of the journey that we have had. Both companies are really trying to grasp the opportunity that's out there in delivering digital solutions to customers, mm-hmm. and really seeing what are the trends in the market and how can we support it with being a trustworthy and respected partner. That's what we've always been aiming for. And we were looking for a way to achieve even more. And I think especially with getting new service offerings that we can supply to our customers and new opportunities that can be for our employees, that really makes the fit, the strategic fit, very, very great. And I know, Heino, that you're very eager to also take these great news out to our customers in the Danish market.
Yeah, and when I look into Valantic, I see a lot of cooperation working and people working together at the customers. And that's very important for us because it's been a part of our journey the last couple of years, is that we need to be at the customer side. We need to understand them and we need to work together. And that's very important in the culture of Inspari, is that we are understanding the customer, but we have to have a team both for the customers at the customer end, but also in Inspari. And that's one of the important things. When I look into the culture, both in Inspari and Valantic, is that it seems like we really want to work together, but we want to work together at the customers. And that's important.
Jens Jakob, I know, according to IDC, 130 zettabytes of data being transferred this year in bytes, 130 with 21 zeros. In the next 3 years, we expect this number to double again. What does this mean for the business models of your clients?
Yeah, so it's an extreme amount of number, and it's almost, you know, hard to grasp that it's actually the amount of data that's been produced. I think for a lot of the customers and the companies out there that we meet, it means that, you know, they are becoming data driven. The digital transformation has kicked in some years ago, and now becoming data driven and really using and leveraging data as an asset, that's on top of the agenda for many companies. And it's very different in terms of the business model of how you use it and how it changes. You use data for improving the customer experience, for instance, and creating new growth and going a new path, creating digital products. But you also use it for optimizing your operations, for instance, becoming more efficient. And I think especially with the use of AI that we also now see, the impact that it can have is just as hard to grasp as the numbers that you just said. Mm-hmm. Because I think we will see a lot of companies, or we see a lot of our customers, really transforming in the way that they work with data.
If you look into the customer segments, they are trying to use data, but they also understand it right now, because the generation who is coming into the customers and they understand knows how to use it, or have an idea how to pronounce and say something with data, so you can talk to the company about how to make better decisions around it.
Inspari is the most respected brand for Microsoft data in Denmark. How did you reach this position?
Well, I think, first of all, we focused on being a data consultancy. We are these kind of people that just loves data. I think that kind of like it brings together people that has the same aspiration, that really loves it, and also are eager to deliver, you know, all of the possibilities that you actually can with data. And then on top of that, we added technology, of course. So we have people that are passionate, but then we also added the technology. And we are a Microsoft company. So we do Microsoft and we do it in the cloud. And when you combine those two things together, so the ability with great technology, which it really is right now. There's so much happening within the Microsoft space. If you combine that with people who are eager to learn and who are also eager to show the world what you can actually do with data, then luckily enough, you end up becoming the leading Microsoft data analytics company in Denmark. And now we are just eager to take that even further.
Maybe you can explain your service offering a little bit more in detail.
Yeah, sure. I think that's relevant for a lot of people. And of course, it's always hard to try to explain what you do in technology. Mm. But we see ourselves as an end-to-end data provider within data analytics. So we start by, or at least we have the opportunity to start by creating the data strategy for a company. It's one of those areas where we are eager to learn even more from the valantic division, because we know that you're very good in here as well. And after that, then we create the digital solutions within data that the customer needs. So that, to some extent, is reporting, it's dashboarding, but it's also more than that, because we work a lot with a power platform from Microsoft. That gives us the ability to also work with automation. So automating processes and also do robotics and other stuff like that. And then of course add artificial intelligence to it as well, so that you can do even more with data. Then we create the data platform that customers need. And as I mentioned, data is an asset, or at least we hope for it to be. And we know that it should be available at least to a lot of people within the organization in a governed structure. And that's what we do, and we create that with the Microsoft Azure technology. And then last but not least, we're also a cloud service provider. This gives us the ability to take the entire responsibility of the solutions and actually have managed services that enables the customer to not worry about, you know, if the solutions are actually working or if they're not working, but let us do it instead. So by having these four different areas, I would say that we at least try to be an end-to-end service provider within the data analytics space.
And what were the biggest changes in your service offering in the last 12 months?
Yeah. I think it's open in the dialogue, and we have seen it for, I think, a year, but especially the last 6 months. We saw that AI was a part that every company who was on the track of using data for more needed to be clever on the artificial intelligence. So not just to put it into a normal day work, but understanding the business case of using data science. Because if you use data science in a way, if you are more like a data-driven company, you have from the start, when you use data, it could be supply chain, it could be e-commerce, but the understanding of data through the value chain, but using data science to take a forecast or to do a prediction about sales and stuff like that. We really saw that now it's the time, because everybody, I will not say trust AI, but understand that AI can be useful if you have, as Jens Jacob mentioned, if you have the right data platform.
But Holger, can I ask you a question? So, why does valantic want to grow in Denmark and in the Nordics?
Valantic is already pretty strong in the German-speaking area and Benelux and in parts of South Europe. Nordics are for us highly attractive because of three reasons. First of all, cultural-wise, we see a lot of similarities. Mm. Discussed before, we are a culture-driven company. Mm. Secondly, the Nordics in the digitalization journey are far better developed than we are in other parts of Europe. So we can learn from the Nordics and especially from Denmark. And last but not least, we never found a company with this Microsoft data experience as Inspari has.
And another question, and that's because, you know, I'm kind of like the person that loves data, but why is data important to you?
Yeah. So data is used in almost all our projects. Mm-hmm. So valantic tries to help our clients during the whole digitalization journey, starting with the digital strategy, going over the customer journeys, the CX journey, touching all the underlying systems, SAP systems or other systems. Data is involved in almost all our projects and is becoming more and more important. What kind of people are actually working for Inspari? Are those all data geeks?
Yeah, at least they love data, as we talked about. But I would say what you need to be a good data consultant is that you need to understand, of course, the technology, and you need to have an understanding of what you can do with data. We talked about that. But at the same time, you need to know people, and you need to know business. So a lot of our people, they're educated from some of the business universities here in Denmark. And then they have the combination with technology as well. And actually, we survey our customers and say, you know, what are we known for? You know, what is it actually that you like with working with Inspari? And the first one is the high skill set they have. So that tells us that at least it's people that are eager to learn and, you know, that have the aspiration to be great. And they also tell us, but it's also people that know how to deal with people and that know business. So it is that combination. And last but not least, they also say that they like us for the quality that we deliver to them. And that tells me that the people that work at Inspari are people that are really proud of their work and that want to deliver something that works and something where you get the value.
Yeah, and we are saying in Inspari that we want to be the best. Mm. And all the history around to be the best has to be internally, but also externally. But the important thing is, if you want to be in Inspari, you're on a growth path. You want to learn from the best. And that's very important for us, because if you're at a customer and they see people really want to change the mindset, they're also challenging the customers. And that's an important thing in Inspari. Don't go over the fence, but stop at the fence if you're not completely agreeing with the customers or the technology platform underneath. We need to challenge the customers, and that's important, and that's clever people who do that. I have a question around the international part of the company, because both Jens-Jarve and I, when we saw into valantic, we saw, oh, okay, this is quite big. A lot of employees is working around the world. And if I look into myself and into our colleagues, what is the story about the international, and what can employees in Inspari choose to or look into valantic and say, I can see the international part for me as well?
So first of all, we are forced to become more and more international because our clients want us to deliver in more and more markets. They are asking, are you able to deliver not only in one country, are you able to deliver in several countries? So we need to react on this ask from our clients. On the other side, I think the countries can learn from each other, technology-wise, process-wise, and also in terms of cultural development. Mm-hmm. Does it mean that all the Inspari colleagues are working tomorrow on other projects which are in other countries? Of course not. But in some projects and for some colleagues who have the wish to work more international, we can offer more and more international projects.
Yeah, and the other way around, we see that our customers want us to take a bigger part of their strategy or their ERP system or stuff like that. So also using the muscle from your side to go into big companies in Denmark or international companies in Denmark, it's also a position we really want to be in.
Thank you for this talk.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Holger, and I really look forward to taking valantic into the Danish and Scandinavian market. It's going to be a blast.